Greetings, everyone. What a joy to be able to speak to you this morning and to greet you. And those of you who may be newer to New Hope or visitors today, my name is Donzie Hunt. Unfortunately, I have been home for several months and have different health problems, but God is healing me and bringing me along. I'm getting better, and I hope to be able to join you all very soon. This, of course, is a very special week as we celebrate our 30th year in the anniversary of New Hope Christian Center. We want to celebrate God's faithfulness, His provision, many miracles along the way, and enabling us all to continue the ministry of New Hope. Now, when Pastor Lee and I first ventured out to start this ministry, God had called us to Spokane Valley here, but there were, of course, many questions. We had no idea how we were going to get it done. And the good news, however, is that God made us able. You see, that's one of the secrets. He will call you to do something, and you may feel very inadequate, but He will then make you. He'll make you ready and able to fulfill what He's called you to fulfill. So we began serving, and we did not know how we would complete it, as I said, but once again, God was faithful to, through these years, bring us many wonderful, wonderful, devout, serving leaders to help us with this church over the years. And I would just like at this time to especially thank Pastor Jim and Belinda for their faithfulness, for their dedication, and for their service to this body. I love them. I appreciate so much their faithfulness and their work here among us. If you are not a pastor or have not been raised in a pastor's home, you have no idea. Trust me, you have no idea what that life is really like. The sacrifices, the dedication, the attacks of the enemy that come are amazing. And you do pay the price. And so please pray for them faithfully. Pray for them and honor them. Honor their leadership and love them. And we'll all move forward together building the church that God had in mind when He thought of New Hope. And you know, I was thinking about God's creation and all the unique and wonderful things He has made that are surround us on every side. And just to think that part of that, He saw a spot in Spokane Valley that needed a church. He had it in mind. He said, okay, I'm going to have a church there. And so he called someone to begin that ministry and move on. So to be part of that grand plan that God has is an honor. It's an honor. And I cherish that honor. I want to thank Pastor Henry Brown in Alsada as well. Thank you so much. Brooke and Aaron, Pastor Aaron, thank you. Thank you for your loving care and nurturing of our youth. We love you for it. And we appreciate you. Now, I'm certain that if Pastor Lee would be able to be here today, he would have lots to say. And he would tell his stories. You know, those of you that know him know what he was like. He would have all these stories. But he's checking us out from heaven. You can be sure of it. He's looking over and he's smiling, seeing how we're doing, and kind of chuckling and laughing. And I can only imagine that he's giving us a thumbs up, which was, of course, his favorite little signal to our family. It could mean for the boys, good shot, or a great putt, or for Aunt, wow, what a great job you did. And Leela, the same. And then maybe for me, he would kind of give it little thumbs up and go, love ya. So it's a good thing. And I think we've got a thumbs up today. Why? God's been honored. Lives have been saved. Bondages have been broken. Marriages have been healed. Bodies have been made whole. And many have been impacted by the Holy Spirit working in their lives through these years. You see, it's really never about how qualified we are, how intelligent we may be, or how skilled we are. Although God does use our natural talent, and he's given talent to all of us, the real success comes when we surrender to his will and surrender to his direction for our lives. We depend on the Holy Spirit working in and through us to accomplish God's purposes. Now, every one of us can do that. Every one of us here this morning can surrender. We can surrender to God and let him work in and through us. Now, with that thought in mind, I think it might be a good time today to evaluate and just think about areas in our lives that need the fresh breath of God to bring healing, to bring maybe deliverance, spiritual revelation. And so for that next step on our journey, let's do that evaluation. Remember Genesis 2:7 says, then the Lord God formed, that is, he created the body of man from the dust of the ground and breathed into his nostrils the breath of life. And the man became a living being, an individual complete in body and spirit. So you see, the scripture reinforces once again, it takes the breath of God to really make our lives complete. Now, I'm sure you see this oxygen cord I'm wearing today. And at first I was very upset I had to use it. And I kind of kicked and squalled about it. But I came to understand that in myself, I needed help in an area in my body to cause my lungs to function more properly. So I begin then to take in breath from another source. Now, just so in the spiritual application of that and understanding, we need to take in breath from another source. We are inadequate in ourself. So lest we get careless, we may slack a little off our prayer life or not be reading our Bible as we know we need to. It's the key to everything. Or just kind of, not understanding. We can never be who we need to be without the breath of God. Without the breath of God, you hear me, without the breath of God in your life and mine, we will never rise to the place that God has in mind for us. So as the Holy Spirit helps us to take this look, perhaps you'll find an area that we need to give attention to, that we might need the victory in, and we're in a struggle. Perhaps some of us suffer from a broken heart for one reason or another, or we have an area that we need healing in. Maybe we're in kind of a dry place, spiritually speaking. Maybe we're still carrying some offenses that need to be healed. Whatever our challenge may be, God wants us to recover from that history and the impact of the enemy on our lives. He's well able to bring all of us to a place of joy and spiritual strength. Joy and spiritual strength. Joy rather than hopelessness. Joy rather than fear. Joy rather than depression. Strength rather than weakness. Strength rather than feeling fragile and unable. Strength is God's plan for us. That's the message of the gospel. We need help from the destruction of the enemy, however that presents itself. And we have that through the penalty that Jesus paid for us on the cross. That's what salvation brought. Deliverance from everything the enemy would bring. And knowing that this can't be done in our own self-effort, we then begin to rely more and more on that Spirit, that breath of God. So, with that said, I trust that you can say, and I can say, that I have made spiritual progress. We can all have, as I said, a wilderness season or other challenges that are difficult. But God is able to work in the middle of all of it, to work in our lives, perfecting and maturing us for our life's assignment. I'm looking forward to days of victory because that's really what God has in mind for New Hope. And that's what God has in mind when he thinks of you and when he thinks of me. His word tells us he's coming back for a glorious church without spot or wrinkle. And that to me speaks of success. That speaks of victory. And so, my dear friends, today we celebrate, but tomorrow we put on our work clothes, so to speak, and we work, for the night is coming. Now, that's what scriptures tell us. Work, for the night is coming. And what's wonderful about that is we get to do that together as a family, as a loving family, supporting and encourage each other. We work together until Jesus comes. Please know that right now I'm a little bit on the sideline, but I'm waving my pom-poms and I'm cheering you all as we enjoy our relationship with God and with the beautiful family that he's given us. So let's dream big. Let's dream big, because our world is messed up. Our world needs a savior. People are desperate. Who's going to bring that message if we don't? And I say, sign me up. Sign me up. I want to bring that message. I love you all. And be blessed today. And I just want to close with a prayer. Father, in Jesus' name, I praise you for the gift of salvation most of all. Your sacrifice, Jesus, and what it means.
Father, for your provision in every way in our life. Strength and helping and miracles and provision. Praise you for all of it. Praise you for all of it, I pray. And I thank you for our beautiful family here at New Hope. I pray God's blessing on each and every family. Whatever the issue may be, if there are challenges, I pray by the powerful Holy Spirit that you would come and give wisdom and solutions, and your power and peace would rest on every home represented here today. We praise you because you are a mighty and a great God, well able to do all that you have called us to do. Thank you, thank you, thank you, God. And we praise you. In Jesus' name, amen.